let x plus minus a. Okay, so it is called lateral shift. What is called? Lateral shift means the curve will shift on right side or left hand side. Whether it will go on that side or on this side. Okay, when you change y, when you change y, so what will happen? Y plus minus a. So this is called vertical stretch. Vertical stretch. So let's stop in this example. Y is equals to x square, it is there. So y is equals to x square x minus 2 whole square. Now what is the effect of x minus 2 whole square? It means x minus 2, to get origin x minus 2 must be 0, because here x, so it is 0. Okay, so for x minus 2 equals to 0, so x equals to 2, it means now the curve will touch not 0 but at 2. So if you plot this curve, so it is not 0, it is 2. Now where is 0 then? 0 will be on the left side. So this is 2, so let's say it is 1, so it is 0. So now what is the difference in this and this? Only the curve shifted on right side by 2 units. Okay, same if you change y, now my y is equal to x square, so the curve is this. When y becomes x square minus 2, so now this is the original y, so my new y is y minus 2 or not, because x square is y. It means y minus 2. So y minus 2, it means what will happen? The curve will go down. How much? 2 units. This is vertical stretch. So the curve will go down. If it is 0, x axis and y axis, then for this curve, the curve would be same, but this point is not 0, rather it is minus 2. So minus 2. So where will be the 0 then? 0 will be upside. Okay, that it is 1 and it is 0. So this is our 0, this is x axis and this is y axis. So this is how the curve changes its way. Transformation. Okay, fine. So let's take another example of reciprocal graphs. Reciprocal and its transformation. Y is equals to 1 by x. Then what is the standard curve? As I told you, 0, x, and y. For minimum value of x, y is maximum, reciprocal. For maximum value of x, y is minimum. Okay, so the curve will be like this and symmetric on other side also, because if x is positive, y is also positive. If x is negative, so y is also negative. Okay, so this is the standard curve. This is 0, x and y. Same if you change the curve like this, y is equals to 1 upon x minus 2. So what will happen? 2 units on right side, because x minus 2, if it is 0, so x becomes 2 then, not 0. Okay, so this line will shift on that side. So if you just copy same, okay, and now draw another line. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2. So this is another line, 2. Okay, and draw the same curve because we have already changed the y-axis. So this will be the curve. Okay, this is first thing, left side and right side changes. And if it is again positive side, then what will happen? Let's say it is x plus 3. Okay, now it is plus 3, not minus. So x plus 3 equals to 0. So x equals to minus 3. What do you call it? Which asymptote? Horizontal or vertical? X equals to minus 3. So it is vertical asymptote. Okay? So for y is equals to 1 by x, the curve is simple. This and this. 0, x and y. Now for x equals to minus 3, the best way is how to fit the curve in the standard x-axis and y-axis. You should plot your x-axis and y-axis, then plot the curve. Now you know this is not 0, because this is 0 only in this case, okay? But in this case it is minus 3, it is minus 3, so it is minus 3. Now where is 0 then? Minus 3 always on left side, so 0 will be on the right side. So let's say 1, 2 and 3 units. So this is your original y-axis and this is your original x-axis. Okay, and this is your curve. So this is best actually, how to make it fit. Now let's take one more example, in which two translations are there, both horizontal and vertical. So let's say 1 upon x minus 3 plus 2. Okay, so if you compare x minus 3 with 1 by x, the difference is 3. Okay, so x minus 3 is 0, so x equals to 3. Now I already calculated the asymptote, vertical asymptote. Now let's calculate horizontal asymptote. How to find? Actually, you should know this number. What is the minimum value of this number? Minimum value of any number, it is 0. It cannot be negative. Okay? So 0 plus 2, it is plus 2. So y is equals to 2. Now I got the new coordinates 3, 2. So what I will do now, because the standard curve is this and this, x and this is y, 0. So I will plot my horizontal and vertical lines, but don't use 0, 0 here, okay? Because my new coordinates are 3, 2. So let's put this number as 3, 2. Okay? Now plot the curve, the standard curve. Now to make it sure that whether we are right or not, so what we will do? We will do particular x-axis and y-axis. So this is x3, so 0 will be on the left side. So 3 units, 1, 2, 3. So this is our 0. And this is 2. So 2 means positive 2, so it is upside, so it should be on the down. So 2 units down, 1, 2. So this is our 0, 0, this is x-axis and this is our y-axis. So whatever we plot over there, they were not original.